today, this afternoon coffee break with you, I want to share with you something that is meaningful to us in the day that we live, because we all desire recognition. Now, people say, oh, no, I don't care if they know. Listen, down deep inside of us, every one of us want to be recognized. Yeah. Well, that's my phone ringing there, but just, take care of that. My kids take care of it, so we don't worry about it. So. Anyway. Yeah. Anyway, we want to continue. You know, we're taping this at the house, and so every now and then we get phone calls and or the cat interfering, but don't worry about it. Anyway, back to the subject. We all want to be recognized at some time or another. And this that I'm talking about today is doing things without getting the credit. Boy, that's hard. Or worse than that, doing something and somebody else takes credit for it. Boy, that burns deep. That burns deep. But anyway, let's look at Jeremiah chapter 9, verse 23. Thus saith the Lord, let not the wise man glory in his wisdom, neither let the mighty man glory in his might. Let not the rich man glory in his riches, but let him that glorieth glory in this, that he understands and knows me, that I am the Lord, which exercises loving kindness, judgment, righteousness in the earth. For in these things I delight, saith the Lord. So, we start off saying, don't glory in your wisdom. You ever been around people that know it all? I have, you know. And if you're around them long enough, you find that they do not know quite everything. They just pretend, okay? They want credit. They want recognition. But the Bible says, let not the wise man glory in his wisdom, neither let the mighty man glory in his might. Oh, wow. I got control. I'm in charge. I'm the boss. Wait a minute. Time out. He said, don't do that. That's not. He goes on to say, neither let the mighty man glory in his might, let not the rich man glory in his riches. Have you ever met someone that really had a lot of money? That bragged about it. Every other breath was about their investments or their company or what was going on. The Bible said, quit it. First of all, those riches, that knowledge, that might, it came from the Lord. And he's the one you need to be praising for it. And you know, I've learned this. You may do a whole lot of things, and nobody will pay any attention. But you know what? My Father in heaven keeps track. And I guarantee you, he knows when payday is to come. So I don't have to go around roaring in anything. But what he says to do, it says, let him that glorieth, glory in that he understands and knows that I'm the Lord. He said, know the Lord. Seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and other things, my money, etc., will be added. That's what Jesus said. He said, seek first the kingdom, the things of God. That's what Jeremiah is saying, way back in the Old Testament. He says, the Lord is speaking here. He said, let them take glory in the fact that they know the Lord, and that it's him that's going to give them loving kindness. No. Let me tell you something. You're going to do a lot of things and help a lot of people that you won't get any credit for. In fact, sometimes they won't even say thank you. Well, that's tough. That's really tough. But you know what? The universe is covered with people who have yet to realize Jesus died on the cross for them. They haven't given him a bit of credit for the fact that they have peace. They claim that they've got it out of a book or something. Let me tell you. Give God the glory he deserves. And then you perform your acts of kindness without expecting any kind of credit for it. I read it in a devotional recently how that one person did so many things and never got any credit for it, and was very disturbed by it until they read Jeremiah and what he had to say about it, straight from God. I tell you what, there's another verse of scripture that goes like, let the one who boasts, this is in Corinthians, let the one who boasts, boast in the Lord. Don't boast about what you have. Don't boast about who you are. Don't boast about the fact that you have the biggest church or the biggest business or the fanciest car. Boast in the Lord. Lift up God. Lift up the Lord. Lift up the things of God. Be blessed. And again, I want you to know your blessing comes from him, not from anybody else. And you just do unto others, here it is, as you would have them do unto you. And if you do that, boasting will be in the hands of the Lord, and you won't be weighted down by the fact that no one recognized you. Bless you. Focus on the Lord. Peace and joy will be yours.
We hope you enjoyed this week's Over the Coffee Cup devotional. Join us each Wednesday for a midweek pick-me-up. And don't forget to visit New Life Christian Fellowship on the web at www.nlcfg2.com.